Hello, I am Izzy Noodles. Welcome to part one of a new walkthrough. This is Fading Light, and it's such a cool game with a piratey theme. There's a lot of secrets to collect throughout the game, and three secrets in particular contain a golden ticket. Find three golden tickets and you unlock the bonus level. So that's something we are definitely going to be doing. Also, this will not be a nomad. There's just far too much opportunity to take damage, unfortunately. Also, this one's a bit tricky and I will do a lot of saving so I don't end up triggering something where I don't want it to be triggered. So we start off in this hotel room. This, I assume, is Lara's hotel room. We've got a balcony over to the right hand side. That door does not open manually, but it does open automatically at some point. So there's actually nothing out there. There's no reason to come back into this room once we've left it. So that's kind of confusing. But anyway, just ignore it. You don't need to come back and go onto that balcony. Behind us, there's the bathroom. We can go in there, and there's a button on the wall to turn on the lights, but that's pretty much all we can do in there. There is absolutely nothing in there, so I won't even bother going in there. There's also this button here, which will turn on the lights. There we go. Let's just waste some electricity. Obvious flares sitting right here. And now let's leave the room. What do we have outside? So we are in a hotel, so let's just come downstairs to the lobby. And who is that? There's a lady. Random lady. So there's also these guys with guns, and if you look at Lara's holsters right now, she does not have weapons right now. So you don't really need to be panicking about these guys until you found your weapons, so they'll leave you alone for now. So next thing we want to do, just press this button behind the counter. Okay, and if we come to the right hand side, we will see what we're doing right now. So we need a key. So two things we're doing right now, find the weapons and find a key. So press this button as well now. So that opens the back door to the yard. And it seems as though the only thing we can do is push this button here, but obviously don't get set on fire. Okay, so it's opened the left-hand door. The right-hand door isn't even a door, so just ignore it. Also, FYI, Lara's pistols are in the bin. What are they doing in the bin? We will never know, but we need to get them out the bin. So now if we come into here that we've just opened up, there is nothing in here, but there is a trigger tile. So if we stand in front of this tombstone, we've woken up a skeleton. So as he's attacking Lara, he can smash the bins, so that's what we want him for. We want him to smash these bins. So yeah, this is a time where you probably will take damage you don't want to take. And the door back into the hotel has opened as well. So we also want him to smash the- ooh, he scared me, I didn't know he was there. Thank you. So there's an important item under that right-hand bin. So I'm gonna save right now because, as I've mentioned, I want to keep saving so I don't trigger things at the wrong moment. I might already be too late, but we will see. Because I did get pretty close to the door when I flipped back from the bin, so that might have bothered some of the guys. So let's get them ready. And the guys in the lobby will attack you now. They do drop stuff. But I will ignore them. I'm gonna do my best to use the key. Wow, far too slow. Okay. I hear him. Ah! Well, that was dumb. I panicked. Never mind. I'll try and be quicker. So So I actually triggered the skeleton again because I don't know if I was in the wrong place and triggered the guys too soon when I didn't want to. I was struggling a bit. Give me a booty poke. Okay, so then sprint on through. I hear footsteps already. Okay, this is fine. Okay, just like that. So shoot that barrier as well, and then come on in. So it can be frustrating if you want to try and do minimal damage. That's the guy downstairs getting confused because I've eluded him. So in here, there's another guy on the balcony. And as I've said, lots of saves. It's mostly to ensure a smooth playthrough. So just try and keep jumping over the enemies. Cool. And try not to jump over the balcony, because that's awkward. That'll just be annoying. Okay, so out here on this balcony, there is this old key. Once you pick that up, you trigger this little cutscene. It's this lady again. Who is she? Okay, it's very mysterious so far. So obviously there's something up with this lady. So now just head back to the pole. There is actually a higher floor that we can go to via the pole. So be aware that the guy might be there. Do your best. So I'm gonna have a little distance because of the guy in case he's right down below. Okay, oh, you tried. You tried. Okay, so now on this floor, there's this door to the left that will open when you approach it, but there is another guy with a gun, so just trigger it and hop back. Wait for the guy to come out, and just keep jumping over him. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Unsuccess, but it was okay. So now let's come into the room. There is a med pack just on this cabinet. And now we can come outside to this balcony. And I always forget about this guy. Okay. More unsuccess going on. It's fine. Okay, so there's no items on this balcony. So from here, the idea is we're going to hop across the buildings now. So we're going to make our way over to there, somewhere over that away. So what we're going to do, you can't see it from here, but we need to produce a rope so we can get to another destination. So that's the idea of going along here right now. So just jump over to this canopy. And this is a place you might want to save because there is yet another guy with a gun. So the reason I'm saving a lot is because I just want a smooth gameplay. So it can get pretty tricky. This is one of the trickiest level editors that I have played. So pull up. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Okay, this is still okay. Still okay. So he drops a large med pack, and while we are in this little section, we can see that there is a little gap through there. So that implies there is a crack in the ledge that we can grab. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna use that to shimmy along. So just run and jump to here. And this is kinda tricky to do. You can't just hang down and shimmy around the corner. Not sure why, but just run forward and hold action, and you should be able to grab that. So, quite often I do try to use minimal med packs, but in this gameplay I am just gonna go ahead and use them if I need to, so it's... This is a pretty tricky one. It's mostly because there are guys with guns, but there is some forced damage as well. So once you climb up there, just jump up to this ladder section. There we go. Okay, and there is a pole straight ahead there. So right below this balcony, there will be, we've not got it yet, but we're going to produce the rope we're going to use to swing to the pole. So also, there is this guy, so he can bother you while you're trying to use the pole. So one thing you can do is shoot him from over here. So you can't really target him very well. He can shoot you from there. You do need a lot of patience for this. It's easier to get him when he's trying to get onto the blocks. So just beware, if he's shooting, he can get you. It might just be easier to jump over and take the shots, really. So she can target that dog as well. She can't hit the dog as well, so that's kind of annoying. Okay, he's finally dead. So that is a very long-winded way of doing it, so it might not be for you. You might just prefer to just take the shots. So anyway, from here, we're heading into that area there. So just shoot out the window. And now I've done that, I don't want to do that again, so let's save. Okay, so you need to do a running jump with a curve. There we go, so just grab that. Inside there is a small med pack. Okay, and on the wall we've just passed a button. Okay, so that's the rope we're gonna use. So it looks like a chain, but it works as a rope. So another guy we can kill from a distance is this guy. This one is much easier. He doesn't move around nearly as much. I say that, but I've barely hit him so far. Nice. So that was super easy. And from here, we can grab a secret. So you will lose half of your health for this secret, so make sure you have got it topped up. And save because it can be a tricky jump. So I always fail to do this. You want to land on that walkway. So I think what I tried was two steps back, three. I don't remember. We'll soon find out. And then one sidestep and a running. Nope, definitely not a running jump. Okay, maybe it was a hop back. Make sure you're all the way and sidestep. So we want to do kind of a banana jump. So when you're lining up for a banana jump, when you hold the look button, you want the wall to be against Lara's shoulder. So kind of like so, in a way. No. I hate these jumps. Who invented banana jumps? Oh, well, that didn't work. I wanted to do a half tile jump. So, avid Tomb Raider fans may have realized, yeah, that was supposed to be a half tile jump that I tried. The half tile jump does not always work for some reason. I cannot answer the question on why. But I'm gonna try a half tile jump now. Ooh. Not quite. Okay. Something like that. It is not easy. It's pretty annoying. So now just hop down, shoot these bins, and we have the first golden ticket. We also have some Uzis, and I believe that is it. So when you're behind these gated sections, you can press a button to get into the street. We actually don't need to, but it's always handy for a shortcut in case you fall down. So we can get back up via this box. And now I'm gonna run over to the rope. Okay, so because ropes, this is a place I would recommend saving. So from the corner, you only need to do a standing jump, and this rope is kind of an interesting one. You get veered off to the right-hand side. So I'm just climbing up to steady the rope and then straight back down again. And I'm gonna aim a little more left of that section where the pole is. So you see how it's just swinging me about? That's annoying. Okay. So there's also a second secret we can claim. So the balcony where the guy was that we shot is up above, but we can jump to this lower one and grab secret two. So just hop down to the crate and we are safe from the dog. Okay, so we've got these revolver bullets and a small med pack. And in the other bin, there were shotgun shells. And the last two times I practiced this level, these shotgun shells didn't spawn. I have no idea why, but there was just nothing in the bin. It's a bit bizarre. But there should be. Just so you know, if you don't find them, there should be some shotgun shells. So also, whoops, not what I wanted to do. So also, just like last time, I've opened up that gate. Okay, and now to the pole, where we're supposed to be heading. So there is still a dog on this balcony, don't forget about that. And it can be tricky to get into the balcony space. There we go. Oops. Managed to jump onto the box somehow. Okay, that's fine. So the guy that we killed did drop a large med pack. Okay, and from here we want to grab this. So we're going to shimmy around now, and if you're having trouble grabbing this, like Lara might just jump up but not grab, just shimmy a little to the left. I think it's just slightly too high or too sloped, and Lara can't quite figure out if she wants to grab it or not. So just sidestep to the left a bit, and then you should be able to grab it. Okay, and here there was another guy as well that we shot, but he does not drop anything. And if you did not open the gates in the secrets, then you could get to item choices, but it's kind of annoying to have to go back through the hotel and do all of that again. So we can either grab some Uzi clips, you can see it just over there, or some flares. So having given the choice, you're probably going to want to go for the Uzi clips. So opening the gates is just a good shortcut back up, so we can grab both of the items, which is what I'm going to do. So I'm firstly going to go for the flares, so just safely drop down and hop the gap, and here are the flares. And when you jump back over, do be careful, because you can overshoot and launch yourself straight into the street. So what we're doing now is the key that we picked up a while ago, the old key, will give us access to a bike. So we're going to use the bike to jump over that ramp. So we're going to try and find the cemetery key now as well. So that's another thing we're doing. We're going to go into the cemetery for the next level. So you see just behind that street lamp in the corner, that's the gate that leads into the cemeteries. You can just make out a little square between the bars, which is the keyhole. So there's two dogs down in this street area. So you can kill them from up here, or you can hop down, doesn't matter. Okay, so firstly I'm gonna go and come back up to grab the Uzi clips. So just push this button to open up this road section. So if you don't want to, you can go ahead and use the bike straight away. So you can either get up through that way, or if you want to cut out trying to use the rope again, just come a bit further down the street this way. And this gate is open. Okay, so hop the block and jump on up. Okay, so we're back on the roof, and now just drop down to here. Make sure you are above the walkway, otherwise you will just become street pizza. Okay, so it's not necessary to pick up both, but I've shown you how to grab both, and you're probably going to want to go for the Uzi clips. Okay, so now I'm going to go get the bike. So on the way to getting the bike, there's a few items we can get in the streets. So come all the way to this end. This is a dead end. But in the bin, there's some more goodies. Never thought you'd find goodies in a bin, eh? So we've got some more revolver ammo. Okay, and if we come down here, so you can see the balconies of the hotel we came from, that's in front now. There's also some goodies over here. And this is the door to the hotel that we started in, so you can see that there is a button on the door. And I'm gonna be a dirty little cheat. Just, you can shoot these guys from out here. Ooh, they don't usually shoot you though. That's new. So I will wait until one of them dies and then I will start being a dirty little rascal. So one reason that I didn't shoot these guys straight away is because we now have the Uzis. Okay, one is down, so I'm gonna now equip my Uzis, and I don't want them to kill me and I lose my progress, so I'm gonna save. Okay, that was easy. So two of these guys drop something, one of them drops flares and the other drops Uzi clips. So if you are struggling, that is one way to deal with those guys. And down to the right hand side after exiting the hotel, here is where you use your old key. So the bike is just behind here. So now just make your way back to the ramp. Okay, so here is the ramp, and you can't just fly forward off the ramp because the gap is too wide. There is water there, and you'll land in it and die. So you'll have to either veer left or right. You have space to do that when you hit the end of the slope. So I know I've only just saved, but whatever. So I get called out on my saving. Well, I haven't done it in a long time, but I feel as though I'm just going to point it out. I don't care. I do care, but whatever. Okay. And there is also a guy with a gun. Oh, sorry, mate. Didn't see you there. Okay. So now, let me just... I'm going to get off the bike so I can show you what's what. That's not the button I wanted. Okay. So you want to use this ramp now to jump over the wall in front, but you can't use it directly forward from the street because there is this raised section. So you have to use this sloped bit right here, and then you can make your way up. So it's a bit trickier because you're not going in a straight line, but it's okay. It's not too bad. So just make sure you have enough momentum, because if you don't, you'll fall down and you will take damage. Not a lot, but it does build up. And there's a guy with a gun as well. See what happens. Okay. So here, behind this section, is the cemetery key. And the doors do not open to let us out, so unfortunately we have to leave the bike here. So just climb onto this block and then up onto the wall, and before you drop down to the other side we can get a secret. Once you've dropped down you can't get the secret because you need the bike to get up here. Okay, I'm sorry I ruined the jazz. Okay, so that is all the secrets of the level. Okay, so I didn't really need to safety drop. I don't think you take any damage at all just there. But now this will be the end of the level, so I'll just go ahead and use the key. And then we can head into the cemetery. Nice! So this is the cemetery. This is where I will be exploring next time. And I will see you there. Take it easy, guys and girls.